Beautiful location, isn't it? Imagine yourself walking through this path, desperately trying to find your destination, which is really unknown. And then you find this bench. So you decide to sit there, relax, and then you're surprised because you see that the path that you've come across has been so beautiful, and your surroundings are actually much beautiful than that. Well, this is exactly how I felt when I took out my time from, you know, the busy job search routine and the assignment schedule, all that, to think about my professional experience and what it means to me today. A very good evening to you all. My name is Madhumitha Elango. I'm here to tell you my professional story in the next few minutes, what it means to me and how it actually began, what I learned through it, etc. So 5 years back, the same November, I made a decision. It was a choice. To choose a career path different from the rest of my classmates who went behind the IT consulting jobs just because they were lucrative. But the job that I wanted was located 1,000 miles away from my home, and my parents were concerned. But I made the decision. I was sure. I wanted this experience, so I moved out of my comfort zone. And then I joined Maruti Suzuki India Limited, which is till date India's passenger car market leader. The three cars on the right side are my favorites, very close to my heart. So this company was started in 1983 when the government of India made a joint venture agreement with Suzuki Japan so that they can make more affordable and economical cars for India. Since then, it disrupted the Indian automotive industry, especially known for its customer obsession. The first 4 months of the onboarding was very enriching because I got to know about the big picture. When I got trained with supply chain, production, you know, administration, engineering, marketing and sales, and all other business verticals. Finally, I chose to work with the engineering division, especially my team was developing electronic control units that would actually control functions like airbag deployment, power steering, keyless entry, and more. The first few months of the on-the-job training was more involved, you know, towards learning the survival skills. Though I was an electrical engineer, I had to learn manufacturing, costing aspects, special mechanical design tools, all these, so that I can work effectively in end-to-end products. The survival skills not only were that, but they were also about learning the cultural difference aspects and learning a new regional language so that I can communicate quick and better with my colleagues and shop floor workers especially. Talking about colleagues and people, yeah, there are a whole bunch of them, right? And being a starter, getting to work with all these people, trying to put your work forward, dealing with all that was quite challenging. But the key was networking. I participated in various events where I got to know people in their most natural form, not just, you know, thinking about job. But during the third year of my work experience came the game changer. My department had changed. There was this new guy. Looking at the way he started criticizing, you know, technical team leads when they were failing in projects, something made me think, okay, so technical skills is not all about success. There's something else that is required. So what is it? As you might have guessed, yes, long story short, that's how Duke MEM happened to me. I came here in August 2013. But the most struggle in the first semester was fitting in the social culture here. It was getting on me. I started noticing that it's affecting me, and it was tough to concentrate. But ironically, the same social events led me to a conversation which turned down to an interview later and then became my internship opportunity as well. This happened way in November, so I was skeptical what to do, but then I accepted the offer because the role was in product development again, which I did it in Maruti back in India. So I wanted to try out how it goes. Given that, I was still low in confidence. So I took the whole second semester to regain myself, to build my own confidence. So I took fun courses like German, and then I tried participating in all sorts of activities. Dr. Murray and Jenny were really, you know, helpful and supportive through this particular phase. And then I crossed it. Came summer, I joined TE Connectivity. This is a very global company that actually makes power and data transmission more efficient. I was with their energy division, industrial energy division, partly working with cable accessories. To be in simple words, it's just about stuff that would actually connect power cables among themselves and with other important stuff. The first few days was really tough because I got to know that product development could be different in different companies. They were doing more of core engineering and research work, and I had to relearn all my engineering basics for that to stay updated and to really understand what they are talking about. But they were really, really supportive. They answered all my questions, and they actually gave me a project that involved both, you know, a blend of the engineering and business aspects so that I could really appreciate well with my MEM program. The main learning from this internship experience was to create your own experience. When I was having like light works to be done or something, I started talking with different people. I approached my team. I said, I want to, you know about how the big picture works, how it all fits. So they welcomed my thought. So I realized that people don't like you when you just, you know, sit there waiting for instructions. People appreciate when you come up with your views. And doing, you know, the same product development role in two different companies, in two different cultures, in two different countries, actually gave me a lot of, you know, insights. I could appreciate the similarities and the dissimilarities. So I just thought I would tell you quickly, like, two different points that I found working in these two cultures. The one was the office style. Madhumitha had an open office culture, so people sit in big halls like that, next to each other. You have halls and halls of people, so it's very easy to contact anyone. You can just get up, walk, and, you know, discuss things with them. But T had more of the cabin style architecture, in fact, own rooms. So scheduling was something that I had to learn, and how to interrupt people, you know, when they are already in conversations, all that. The other thing was the work pressure, or the work style, I would say. T was more relaxed. People had their own independent, you know, space where they could make decisions all over. But Marzi, it was more of walking on fire every day, running behind deadlines, you know, following a lot of hundreds of process before getting your activities done, all that. So, looking into all this, I actually feel that the MEM program and my past experiences, they've made me more of a matured person right now, better prepared, you know, to face the real corporate world again after my graduation. Out of all the feedbacks that I received from my peers and my student peers, of course, I feel that the sincerity and dedication is what people appreciate in me, but I also have to work upon my emotional intelligence, trying to be more upfront and, you know, not assuming things just the way they are. So these are something that I learned through all these experiences. And to top that, finally, all the recent past has actually shown how important my parents are to me, about their sacrifices, all that they did, you know, so that I could be happy and I could do what I wanted to do. So I've decided to put them as my top priority and, you know, prioritize my life according to that, definitely. So having said that, let's move to the only slide in my presentation where I consciously added text. Thank you so much for listening to my story. And the last 1 year and few months were really, really enriching. I really got some very sweet friends here, though not a big circle, but very close to my heart here. And special thanks to Professor Greg Twist, because his five-hour session on you know, visual presentation design actually made changed my mind. It made me think, you know, rethink the way I make presentations. So I'm trying to start trying new things in every presentation, so this was one of that. And thank you, Brian and his wife here, you know, who has joined us today here. That's because Brian was my buddy, my mentor, my colleague at my summer internship. So he just wanted to be here, and I hope he would really enjoy the presentation, other presentations and the student environment here. Thank you so much. Really appreciate it. Have a nice evening.
Any questions?
Yeah. If you have any questions, yeah, I'm open to take them. Please go ahead.
Could you elaborate on your day-to-day profile, would you actually work in your internship?
Okay, in my internship, again, like I said, the team was product development. So we were making components for customer-specific applications. I mean, the work role that I'm talking about, it's mine. So we were involved in testing. So a lot of customers are like, the customers are like utility-based or large companies who want to adapt all these power cable accessories for their systems. So there are a lot of regulations in place, so a lot of qualification tests that needs to be done. So we were prepared, like the most of the daily work, it goes into monitoring the testing and also reading standards so that you understand, you know, what sort of testing you need, what is the requirement of the customer, all that. And the business side, of course, once the testing is done, you should get the thing in reality, right? Whatever you tested, whatever change you make, that should go into the production floor. It should go and ultimately get sold to the customer. So that is what the main aim is. So the business aspects come, you know, once you are done with your qualification, once you get approval to, you know, integrate the change. So you discuss with other teams like supply chain and then with product management. So you ask them, okay, you know, what update should be done at your end. And then you interact and then you do all that changes along with them. And then finally, it gets updated. Yes, it goes to the production floor. And in the meantime, you also need to interact with your customer because you have to constantly update that, okay, you know, we are doing this for you. This is what the update is. You know, we made a prototype. Why don't you try this and see all that? So this would be the work content, and it's kind of spread it over. Day-to-day, it definitely differs. It wouldn't be the same.
You were actually testing or you were monitoring the work?
Both. That's why I said it was a mix of both technical and business role. Any other questions? All right, thank you so much.